Hi there, world. Dolphin Doug in Juneau. Today I'm going to talk about what to do in bear country if you happen to come across a bear. I'm out at the Mendenhall Glacier Visitor Center in Juneau. It's at the end of October. The chance of me seeing a bear is almost zero. But this is bear country. These heavy gauge, These heavy gauge fencing, this is to keep the people from coming and going. And it's built so well with little accesses so the critters can come through if needed. This is bear country. 600,000 people maybe come out here in the middle of our busiest season from May through September, a little bit in April and October. It's the same time the bears are around here, and there are something like 40 or so bears that regularly frequent this area. Big males, medium-sized females, little tiny babies. If you go for a walk on some of these trails, you could run into them at any time. And the proper thing to do, if you come up to a bridge like this and there's a bear coming along towards you, the proper thing to do is to be courteous and let the bear go where he wants. If I were doing that, I would back up and talking the whole way and move to the side and let the bear go, and I would make sure I have my camera out and I'm watching that bear go beside me wherever he wants to be. I have seen a bear right here. I saw it because there were at least 50 people stacked in this little area right past it, and a bear wanted to go towards the people and couldn't make it through. The big thing with the bears is let them go where they want to. They've got a hard job here. They can't go down the Safeway like you can. After the bear's gone, I go for the walk again. If you're walking in bear country, talking like this or even quieter is perfectly appropriate. Now, you should notice, if I'm here by the creek noise is pretty loud. If I was a bear down beside the creek, the bear's not going to hear you very well. They're a little bit oblivious to what's going on around them. You can watch them, but you don't want to be messing with the bears because the food is really important to them. We do not have a problem in Juneau, but there have been troublesome bears. Alaskans tend to shoot them. Troublesome ones. These bears, many of them have been here year after year. These trails back in the woods, these are likely, sure looks like a person trail to me, but as you walk through the woods, you're going to see trails like that in regular places. Here's another trail. It's not nearly as nice. It's not as obvious. That, to me, looks like a bear trail. Now, this is all, I'm walking through the woods just on a trail, minding my own business. I'm looking around at everything I see. This is bear country, so they're there. Now, this part of the woods, back here, that was a bald eagle. There's no food out here in this part of the woods. There's no food for the bears. There's no food for the eagles. There's just literally nothing out here unless you're a porcupine. The creek is full of food at just the right time of year for both the bear and the eagles. Although eagles, this is not a favorite feeding spot for eagles. They can travel so easily and so far, they go other places to find their meals. Although today I've been pleasantly surprised. I heard that one, but I've also seen three other adults and a juvenile eagle up in the trees in a place where this is a pretty backwater country for an eagle. But whatever, you know, I don't make decisions and they can go wherever they want to. It's a miserable day. It's been precipitating all day. You can see how important it is to have a hat. And it makes my world so much better because I'm walking around in rain without being rained on. This hat makes the world a difference. If you come to Juneau, you should wear rubber boots. They work. These are called extra toughs, and the locals swear by these things. I've worn other brands of boots. I keep buying my extra toughs. They're now made in China, unfortunately, so they don't last nearly as long, but they still serve the purpose. I've got property down in Tennessee, and I go down there on the flats of Tennessee, and it's mud country. Extra toughs are terrible in mud, but this stuff, very little of it's mud. This is very, very fine sand, and it cleans up real easy. So anyway, you're going to want a hat like this because it makes your day so much better. It was 36 degrees, the temperature on my truck's thermometer this morning. it could just as easily be 46 degrees and it would look exactly the same. In the middle of the summer, it might be brighter, but if the cloud cover were heavier, it would look just like this to you. So prepare for this, prepare for the worst, and you could be better. And what you don't want is high wind and high rain, and we occasionally get that. There's nothing you can do coming to this beautiful place and avoiding that 100%. Come in the middle of summer, you're more likely. October is notoriously the worst month of the year weather-wise. Right now, this is just typical. So come on out. This is curious because this is a big major trail and I can see green in the asphalt. There aren't very many people that use this, even in the middle of the summer. There's lots of stuff out here to see. Now, we did just have 2 years of COVID, and this past year was absolutely a very partial year as far as we did have cruise ships come back, and we're glad to see them back, and the cruise ships were partially full, but it wasn't nearly as busy. And if you didn't come up here, you need to come up here. Number one, the glacier's leaving. Number two, it's going to get more crowded, and that's no fun. Now, look at this. This is kind of cool. Why is that mesh around that? It's to keep the porcupines from eating the sign. No dogs allowed. I didn't know that. Well, I guess that's good to know. There are lots of dogs around here. There are lots of locals with dogs. The bears, these are human trails. The way you can tell the difference between a human trail and a bear trail is a human trail, I can walk down without having to bend over. Bear trails, you always have to bend over. Now, yeah, up ahead I would need to. Another neat thing with bear trails, and I'm going to start looking for it. I don't have any bear trails right here. But a bear trail, if the bear has to brush up against a tree or something heavy, it can pull hairs out. And you can find just a little wad of bear hair. I've done that. You can find brown bear and black bear hair. It's going to be at bear height. But as I go this way, I'm getting away. I'm getting out on the flats. Yeah, shoot. You can't even see. There's a tiniest wisp of a mountain back there. But there's a big mountain on that side. On this side, we've got to go. I can see the far side of the valley, but it's a mile off that way. And so the bears don't come out here very much because there's not much to eat. Oh, look at this. Look at that. Beaver. Don't know any idea why that beaver was out here. He can't eat that tree. That's why he left it. Maybe he could. Oh, I thought it was a spruce tree. He could eat it. But the beaver have to crawl from the stream. And it's a... Another beaver. Is that beaver? So you can tell. Yeah. I can see tooth marks here. I mean, it's old. These are a couple years old. But there's been a beaver messing around here. What makes the beaver nervous? Wolves. Wolves eat beaver. I have to do a story on Romeo, because Romeo was our resident wolf for a couple years. Most beautiful, wonderful, all black, huge thing. And here's another one. A lot of beaver. I mean, it's not a huge and dynamic thing, but these, is beaver doing the trouble, not humans chopping. There you go. Classic beaver tree knocked down. So they were living in this creek, and there are beaver around here. I'm on the far side of the creek. Here we go. Right over here. See this little pond? That's a pothole. Not as big as the biggest pothole in Juneau that I just showed, but that's the second biggest maybe. Nice, clean, clear water, has no real connection to the creek that's right over here. Doesn't make any sense geologically unless you've got glaciers pushing all this dirt and mud and rocks around. And then you say, oh, well, that makes sense. And in 1,000 years, you'd get some, it'd look like Wisconsin, and you could barely see the evidence anymore. So, yeah, bear country. I'm not going to see a bear, but come on out. Look for them. Enjoy yourself and talk. You don't really want to carry the rules with the Mendenhall Glacier Visitor Center is you should not have food with you. If you go for a hike out on these trails, I don't. You should not have flavored drink with you. I don't. I follow those rules because I can, because I live here and I can eat anytime I want. But when I go out hiking in the woods, I have food and drink with me all the time. Bears don't mess with you. Now, it is a big deal in that these are the habituated bears that see people all the time. The last thing in the world we want is them to turn into Yogi Bear and start demanding food. So I agree with them as far as that goes. We treat bears out in the wild. We have so few people. It doesn't happen very much. There you go. Just a nice little, no fish in this thing. There's no food in this thing to speak of. I mean, there might be a couple little things, but it's not worth effort. It's so many months out of the year. There's just no sunlight. It's frozen over some of the time. Juneau freezes hard. We could walk out on this pond, no problem, but it could also any day of the year could be completely wide open and ice free. So stay warm and dry. Hope you have extra tufts, and come on up. Enjoy our liquid sunshine.